So, welcome to my talk, Refactoring to Clean Code. I'm Tim Verdin. I'm at Trivago since November, so I'm pretty new. But I've done refactoring of old and bad code a lot of times in my work life. And yeah, this mostly is based on the book Clean Code from Robert C. Martin, who has also made most of the SOLID principles that should be familiar to everyone who codes. This book is also available at the Trivago library, so you should check it out. And I also recommend everyone who is programming to have this book on its own. So we'll mostly show it directly, and yeah. Okay. So I have a class here. Okay, that's bad. Yeah. Awesome. Okay. So this mostly consists of this beautiful run method, which has a lot of for and each and try and ifs, and well, it's pretty hard to read and to figure out what's going on here. So most of us know that a class should only one thing, but methods should have the same principle. So methods should also do just one thing, and they should therefore only consist of about 20 lines. So this is a lot more than 20 lines, and so let's try to refactor this and clean this up a little bit. So first we have an if condition here that's just doing some logging, and we see we have directly an else. And if we scroll down and just skip all the stuff, we see, okay, that's the end of the function, so nothing else major is happening. So why don't we just step out of the code at this point? So we can just return its void method. And my IDE directly says, tells me that here's something going on, because I can now split the workflow, and now I've reduced the complexity, and it's a little bit easier to read already, because I know, okay, after this lock, there will be nothing else. I don't have to bother reading anything besides this, if that's what I wanted to know. So then we continue. So we have a loop here. And again, we have an if condition, which does a lot of stuff. And if we look further down, we also have an else condition that's only doing some logging. So we can make this easier as well. We can say it flips the condition. And now instead of in array, it will be not in array. And I can also stop at this point. So as we are in a loop, we do not return, but we continue with the next loop. And again, we can split the workflow. And it's already easier to read what's happening here and why this lock is present at all. And then we have this try-catch. Okay, this is fine. So let's go into the while. And again, we have an if condition that does a lot of stuff, and an else that does only logging. So we can do the same thing again. And split the workflow. And we already see that instead of indenting everything 5-6 times, we are now down to maybe 3 or 4 times, which is a little bit easier to read and understand. And now comes the point where we should check what the code is actually doing and what we can gather together into just one function. So I look at the code here and I see, okay, I'm just downloading a file here. Okay, that's just one step, so nothing major is going on. Then I initialize an XML iterator, and I already think, well, XML iterator, what's it's iterating it. So I don't think this is a fitting name for this because I have an XML, I read it, so it's more likely an XML reader. So I start renaming it so that I better know what's the use of this variable. After that, we go over some elements of this XML and do a lot of stuff. So I immediately see that I'm initializing XML and processing it. So this is, in my opinion, one thing that I can already exclude. So I can refactor this to a method and say, okay, process an XML. And now this is already a lot easier to read, because if I don't bother what exactly is processed or how it is processed, I can just read, okay, it's processing XML, and go on with my reading. So now this function is a lot smaller and already easier to read. I can even go ahead and refactor this again, because I'm processing one of the files I have in the first variable. So I have to change this first, because otherwise the IDE is complaining. Okay, say makes this a new function, so he don't want to process file, and we use the file path. So then I can file and put this again in a separate method. And now the run method is already a lot smaller, but some of the variables are now not used anymore, of course, because they were used down here. So I can, of course, get these and move them out of here, and also move them over to this part, which makes it a little bit easier already. Next, I have the problem that we had some written rows here that I used later on, but I'm not returning these. So it's a little bit harder now. And we always want to use as less parameters as possible, because the more parameters you add to a method, the more the user has to guess. For example, if we have a unit test and we have the assert method, what's coming first, the actual or the expected? Well, usually looks this up in the documentation, but nobody knows out of the head. And the more and more parameters we have, the more likely people have to guess things. So that's why we try to have as less of these as possible. So an easy way for the written rows, for example, would be just to make it a field. So now it's in our class, and we do not have to give it as a parameter, because we are still in the same class. Of course, now I have to do this here again. And we are already, again, a little bit cleaner. So the same goes with here. We have the written rows that are not here anymore, so we can remove this over here and over here. And of course, we have to change this here. Now we see, well, we do not need to return the written rows anymore. They are in the class, so we can skip the return and make it a void function, which makes it again easier, because now I don't have to bother with any return values. So next, we have this partner ID, and if we look, well, it's basically only used once, very down there and nowhere else. So why are we using this as a parameter instead of removing it here? Also, of course, when calling the method, and just put it over here, where we actually use it. And now we only have two parameters, which is a little bit easier. And of course, we can do the same with the reference list. But, well, I see the reference list is used here, so that's not a good idea. So again, I could make this just a field. And I can remove this here again. And I only have one parameter, and I want to process an XML. I give it the path to the XML. That's pretty forward. So you can easily just know what's going on. So of course, I have to change this here as well. And why is he not recognizing the? But thanks. And this is now active partner references. So now this is already a lot more readable. But again, we have a function that is doing a lot of stuff. So we are getting an image here. We are checking for some condition that breaks the loop. And then we are getting some more information just to write it down. So I think it's a lot better to move this again to a new method, which is again not doing because of the continue. So we move this for a moment. And let's call it get image data, because we have this image method and we are basically getting additional information on this image. So now, because before it was several variables, the IDE makes this list statement, and I don't really like this, because if I have an array, I can just use the image, the array. So let's call it image data. And use this now as an array. This we will need later. Image data URL. So now this method is a lot more readable, because if we get the image data, we write it, and that's basically what's going on here. So I do not have to read again how the image data is retrieved. And so I would, of course, like to clean this up here as well, because I now need an array which has these keys, of course. So let's move this. Which data is an array. Okay. So we can get our comment. The category number. And the URL, which was just this. Of course, this is currently a little bit more complicated because I moved it, and before we had this continue here, so we are breaking the process at this point. And so I have to reintroduce this, and of course I have to remember to do this. So I'm returning just an empty array because I do not have the data that is necessary. And of course now I have to check for this here as well. So if our image data is empty, I again continue, so I don't want to write it. Okay, so one thing I also don't like is this if condition, because it's pretty long, it has this string pause, which is basically hard to read for everyone. So I like to move complicated if conditions also into a method that is a lot more readable. So I check this code and I'm seeing, okay, obviously there's an URL that has a hard-coded value, do not delete, no hotel media. So why are you not doing this? No, it's going, okay. So we call it has no media URL. And now it's a lot easier to read, right? Because this if condition was very hard to interpret for anyone, even me as a programmer, even probably as the one who had written this. But now I can just read if has no media URL, log it, and return the empty array. So I have already reduced the complexity as a reader a lot. And I don't think it's much of an issue to have a small function here that just returns this one Boolean. And even if this is just one line, this is pretty fine because it's easy to read and understand if I want to understand it. If not, I can just read the method name and already know what it's doing. So this was one of the examples, and I think now this is a lot clearer to read and understand. I can directly go to the point where I need to make changes. So for example, I had to make changes to downloading the file because this was sometimes not working and we want to retry it. So I can just go ahead and make a new method. Try downloading file, which I can then easily refactor to do this additional stuff. So let's see. No, this combination. So try catch. Because the download file will throw an exception if the file is not present. So I can just say, okay, if retries slash zero, and if our retries smaller than, let's say, five, is equal to five, we throw this exception because we still want to stop at a certain point, and otherwise we sleep a second and just try this again. No. File path, file name. Now I again have one method name that's pretty easy to read up here where it is actually used. somewhere here, try downloading file. And I have a pretty small method that everyone can read pretty easily. No. Yes, I should. Yeah. yeah, then while retries smaller 5. I mean, it's just an example. Okay, so I think like this it will not work. Of course, you should always run your unit tests that should be present, because even if you are just some simple refactoring like this or add a simple feature like this, something can break. And that's why you should always have tests, of course. So I have just another example, because I think we are fine with this class. So we have this nice little filter here. So again, we have some, I'm skipping a little bit here because we are short on time. So I'm going to the main step. So we are initializing some files and so on. We are reading over it, and for each line, we apply some filters. And then we have this awesome construct of if, else if, which is horrible to read. Especially when I read this code the first time, and especially this middle part here, it took me about 5 minutes to figure out what this code is actually doing. And I even had to write down a little logic table to get everything right and to be sure that this if-else construct is doing what I think it was doing. So this is also something that you should always clean up. Robert C. Martin, who wrote the book, referenced to the Boy Scouts. Always leave the campground cleaner as you found it. And that's also the same thing you should do to code. Yeah? So if you encounter something like this because we have to work on this file, refactor it, make it cleaner. Because if you encounter it again, you will already have forgotten what you have read there and what you have understand out of this. So why not just clean this up immediately? So this time I make it a little bit different because I see, okay, I'm 2 times checking the filter. Well, I think I can do this just once. I have a result of this. And as I told you, I've made a logic table. So if this and this is true, then I have a certain outcome. And if it's not true, I have another outcome. So I made this table and I found out, well, in the end, what this if condition is doing, it's basically just turning around the result. So I can just do this because the result is a Boolean. Unequal result. Like this. And now it's the other way around, and it's already a lot easier. And now we have these if conditions for AND and OR. And I can also move these out and just use them once. So, thanks. If the result is true and it is an AND filter, we can break. And if it's not a valid result and we have an OR, we break again. So I can now remove this. And I think this is already a lot more easier to read than this giant construct we had before. Of course, this needs a little bit of more logic thinking, and it took me maybe 10 minutes to do this. So it wasn't just an easy task. I could make it now very easily because I've already done this 2 times. You should invest always this time, because you will at some point in your career, or one of your colleagues will encounter this code. And if it's hard to read and you have to change anything at this point, it will take you then more time, and again and again and again, whenever someone has to encounter this code. And so that's why it's pretty important to always refactor. And even if it's just a little bit, if you are working on one function and this function is messy and you have to add some code, add a feature in this function, at least refactor this one function. Leave the code cleaner as you found it. And then your life will be much easier, and also the life of all your colleagues will be easier. And over time, you will probably have some very clean code, especially if you do this also for all the new code you write. So you remember to have small functions that only do one thing, and it will be much easier to read, to not refactor, but to modify, to add features. And yeah, that's probably all I can say to this. Thank you.